Hey guys, and thank you so much for tuning into my channel. My name is The Lady Designer, and today we are back with Prehistoric Kingdom, and we're going to build a habitat for the Lambeosaurus, the last dinosaur from the poll that we did on the community wall. So that means that the next one will probably be the T-Rex or the Microraptor. Do I need to do another poll for that? I don't know yet. I will just let me know in the comments down below what you guys like to see first, but I'm guessing it's going to be the T-Rex. So I actually forgot that I mentioned in the last episode that I wanted to start focusing more on the terraforming of the whole map before adding a new habitat, but I just completely forgot. I just looked at the poll and I was like, oh, okay, it's the Lambeosaurus this time, so okay, let me just see where I'm going to add a habitat for it. And that's how it happened, and I started working on a habitat. And when it was finished, I was like, oh yeah, wait, didn't I say that I wanted to do some more terraforming and stuff in the last episode? So yes, I'm sorry for that. So this habitat will be a little bit more coastal again, also because it's basically connected to the coastal habitat for the Styracosaurus. And I don't know, I just found it more fitting, and I just really like to play around with that biome as well. So I just really, really like that. And I also really wanted to play with multiple viewing galleries. So I did just took the one from the Styracosaurus from the boulevard that we had, and I actually made smaller viewing galleries from that and put those around the habitat. So there are three of those shorter viewing galleries around the habitat, but there's also going to be one a little bit more raised. I don't think you can call it really a tower. It's just a round little viewing gallery with some kind of canopy above it, and I think it just looks really cute, and it's definitely something I also want to play around a little bit more with in the future. It's also something I do sometimes in Planet Zoo, so it's definitely also trying to see like what kind of things you can do in this game and how does that work, because it's definitely different, to be completely honest, especially because we are not able to like raise our path, for example. So yeah, I had to play around with the terrain tool, which also wasn't really didn't really feel like super comfortable, so I had to play around with that a lot. I think I definitely need to learn a little bit more how this one works. It definitely feels different from the one in Planet Zoo. And yeah, well, since we can't really raise the path or anything, you just either have to build a path from custom pieces, or you have to, raise the terrain and make a nice smooth slope for it, and then being able to connect the path to the viewing gallery on top of the little hill, going down to the other path to connect it. So yeah, it was definitely a kind of a struggle. but yeah, the viewing gallery itself, that little round one, is definitely super cute. I do notice a lot that the 3D gizmo is not always properly working, so that is really a pity. Sometimes really have to tweak things and stuff, but I'm sure, like, this is still the alpha, so I'm sure that those kind of things will be fixed in the future as well, so I think that's going to be fine. As well as the 3D gizmo to rotate items. I don't know, I was trying to work on the canopy, and for some reason, it just didn't really go super smooth, and I was really sure that I just angled everything at 5 degrees, but for some reason, one side was just not aligned with the other side. I have no idea what happened there. But it was easy to fix at the end because, well, one half I could just duplicate to the other side. But yeah, these are definitely things you are just trying and see how things work. And it's all fine, I guess. This is an alpha stage still. But talking about the alpha stage, they actually, when you're watching this video, it's already quite some time ago probably. And we're maybe already out of the alpha. This is still an alpha build. But they actually released a devlog. I will post it in the description so you know about what devlog I'm talking about if they release any new ones later on. But yeah, they released a devlog and they announced that they're guessing that somewhere in April the alpha stage will end and that we're going into beta, I'm guessing. So that is really cool. That is also very promising for the game. So that means that a lot of things are already going really well. I do hope that the 3D gizmo will be fixed during the beta. I think that's definitely something that we would need. Unfortunately, I talked about the undo button in one of the previous episodes, that one is missing. That one is going to be missed probably until the early access build, for what I've heard. So there is an undo button in the screen, but you unfortunately cannot use it. So that is definitely something that, at least for me, would hold me back to do like really crazy things. Like, oh, I can. It's so often that I put down items and then I'm like, oh, I want to do Control C. Okay, never mind, you know? So that kind of feeling, like I don't really want to click everything again to delete it myself, for example. So sometimes you're just like, oh, well, okay, never mind. I will just keep it in then. But yeah, it is something that will be added in a later stage, obviously. So all the viewing galleries will be surrounded by a lot of rocks. Guess what? Rocks, yes, I just love the rocks in this game. They're just super beautiful and they work so well. And in this case, I really wanted to focus a little bit more as well onto the surroundings of the viewing galleries. So yeah, I really focused on where I wanted to put the path and where I want to, I want to surround everything with a lot of rocks. I really want to make it feel very natural. But the difference is that right now I'm playing around. Oh, I'm going to use the brush. Of course, I'm going to use the brush, but I'm also using a lot more of the single placement, and especially like this flat green bush that you're seeing. I have no idea what the name is from it, but that one I'm using a lot to actually just cover the grass with. I don't know, I find the contrast with the rocks together with that green flat bush just really, really good. And together also with the wooden fence I'm later placing, I think it just, it's so simple, but it just really does a lot with your surroundings. So I really do love that. And other than that, I did try to use the brush a little bit to put down some plants and stuff, but that didn't really felt super smooth. So in the end, I decided to just put down a lot of the plants and trees myself. So really, being able to choose where you want to put everything down. And I think that sometimes just definitely works better than just using the brush, even though the brush is still like super useful. And I did use it a lot for the inside of the habitat as well. So the habitat itself will be a combination again of the tropical and wetland biome, and especially the wetland around the water, because I just really love the texture of that terrain painting. I think that looks absolutely amazing. And I think for the habitat itself, the trees and bushes I used was from the scrubland biome. And I think this combination, especially with the palm trees and stuff, just really works well, in my opinion, with the coastal biome. And I actually first wanted to pick the Lambiosaurus with like the stripes. I think there's still one in there, but in the end, I tried to pick a more brighter color just to get some more colorful contrast into the habitat, because I just really like that. And the one with the stripes, I think I forgot to remove one, but that one just blends in a lot more into the coastal biome. But yeah, the reason why I picked the colorful one in the end was just because of the contrast. I really wanted to get a little bit more contrast in, but I do honestly feel that the colored one will fit more in like a tropical jungle biome or anything like that. So maybe I will just make another habitat for that one as well, with a totally different biome in the end. But yeah, as I said, I have no idea. It could definitely be that once we're starting with the beta, that I will lose the progress of this park and that we have to start over with something. But then at least we had some practice and stuff, and I'm just really excited to see what other things will be added during the beta. Maybe we're also going to get some extra animals in. I have no idea, to be completely honest, what exactly is the plan for the beta for the game. So that's going to be a pleasant surprise probably, because I really have no expectations for it. Other than I'm expecting that it's going to be super good, so of course. So one of the viewing galleries will also have a restroom connected to it. I don't know, I just felt like there was this empty spot and I wanted to fill it with something, and I thought like the easiest way is just to add another restroom in. I mean, it's a little further away already in our park, so I can imagine that our guests do have some needs and stuff, so I think they will definitely be happy with a restroom somewhere around here. It's quite a long walk. We don't have any rides or anything, so yeah, the guests really do have to walk, and it also helps for a little bit of shade, I guess, and just to relax. But obviously, they can also relax at the bins at at the bins, at the benches that we put down on the viewing galleries itself. I do hope there will be a little bit more variation for it. I actually also hope that we're going to see some picnic benches. I don't know, you probably have not played Planet Coaster, but if you did, during the development of the game, there was one thing that we really, really wanted, and that was picnic benches. And we were always creating our fake picnic benches, but no one was ever using it. So when there was like this big event and they were announcing what the new update would be for the game, and they announced picnic benches, like, everyone from the Planet Coaster community went just completely insane about it. And now thinking back to that and looking at this game, I'm like, I'm actually curious if there are going to be any picnic benches, because right now, especially also with Planet Zoo, it's like, just like, yeah, of course we have picnic benches. But I have no idea if that's, I guess it will be added as well in Prehistoric Kingdom. I'm just really curious if that's going to be added during the beta or maybe with early access or maybe after that. Like, I can also see that it's not really a priority at this point. But yeah, I can definitely see that being added in the future. Also, in one of the previous episodes, I was talking about underwater viewing galleries, and you guys were commenting that there are plans for aquatic and semi-aquatic dinosaurs and animals in the game, so that there is a plan for the developers to also have some kind of underwater viewing galleries. So I'm actually really, really surprised about that. I'm really curious to see how they are going to pull that off with the game mechanics, and especially because the brush, it doesn't really feel like volumetric. So I'm actually really curious how they're going to implement that into the game. Like, I'm not a developer, so I have no idea how hard these things can be, but I can imagine that can be quite a struggle. So yeah, I'm in general just really curious to see when that is going to be added and how that is going to be added, and if that is going to be able to be added with the current water brush, which is just super easy to use. So yeah, I'm just super excited about that, and I do wanted to share that with you guys, because I can imagine that is also something that you guys are curious of, to know if there are any plans for that. I have obviously no idea when that is going to be implemented. That could be something that might be implemented somewhere in early access in a year or maybe even later. I honestly have no idea. But obviously the developers have a huge passion of building and creating this game, and they obviously want it to be the best dinosaur game out there, I guess. So all the feedback and all the wishes of people, they're definitely trying to listen to that and see what they're able to implement. But obviously it's a very small team, so it's not like all things can happen all at once. So yeah, things take time to develop, but hey, we all have time and we don't mind, so we will just wait and see until there is any news more about that. And I will obviously keep you guys updated for whenever I hear some more news about that. But yeah, I'm in general just really happy with how this habitat and the surrounding area has turned out. It's definitely already different again from what we did with the previous habitat. It feels more dense, it feels more closed off, I guess, if you can call it that way, with like the rocks and stuff around it. I feel like the graphics are definitely looking really nice in general, with like the rocks and a combination of the foliage. So I don't know, it just all feels just super natural and super realistic. Oh, I'm not really sure if it's realistic. I don't know. You tell me what you guys think of this new habitat and the surroundings for the Lambeosaurus. Leave a like at the video if you guys enjoyed, and subscribe, of course, if you haven't already. And if you want to support the channel a little extra, you may want to consider to become a FAFM member with the join button of YouTube, which you can also get some early access videos if available. So definitely go and check that one out. You can also find me on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and all those other social media pages. So definitely go and check out the links in the description down below. And yeah, thank you guys so much for watching, and I really hope to see you guys all in the next one. Bye, guys!